Welcome to my first unboxing video. The point of this is I used a really weird service that a lot of people don't know about called Sendico. And when you see what I got and what I paid versus what I could have paid, you'll kind of figure out why I'm freaking out about this in a good way. What Sendico is a company that they're considered a proxy service. What that means is they will bid on Japanese online auctions for you and communicate with the seller, and they, like, you can win a bunch of auctions and they gather up all the stuff at their warehouse, and when you're ready, they'll box all of it up, wrap it really well, and send it to you. And as a result, you end up paying a lot less than you would for getting stuff on eBay. So let's see what I got, and then we'll go over, like, the price stuff. I probably shouldn't keep hitting that mic. So. Oh my god. They, like, do not half-ass this at all. I got a Super Game Boy, too. It's notable because the real Super Game, well, the original Super Game Boy runs at, like, 0.2-something percent faster than an actual Game Boy. This runs at the right speed and has a link port, which is funny because then, like, if you play multiplayer games, like, one person's going to have a Game Boy and one person's going to be on the TV. Gah. This is actually complete, which is unusual because there are several inserts. That's what it looks like because it's, what, 1997 when this came out? 96, 98? I don't know. Either way, it was the late 90s, so everything had to be transparent. That's that. This is... this is a tiny gachapon pouch that looks like the Sega SG-1000. Absolutely no reason to own this whatsoever. But I'm going to use it as a replacement for a wallet, because I think it's fucking sick. It's like a teensy little kind of clutch almost. They made a whole bunch of these. Like, you can actually get, like, the SG-1000 shitty joystick controller that everyone hated, and, like, a Mark III and a Master System and a Game Gear and blah de blah de blah. And it actually still has the little paperwork thing from the vending machine in it. Next is something considered to be one of the better SG-1000 games, kind of, programmed by Compile and released by Sega. It's Hustle Chumy, and I got this. It's a little beat up, but it's complete. The cartridge and manual are in pristine condition. That's sick. The box is a little gnarly, but when you see what I paid for this, you'll understand why I got this. Oh my god. At the end of, I believe, 1990, they put a version of Lunar Lander out for Game Boy that was, like, a little tricked out and has more than just the Lander stuff in it. You can get Lunar Lander for the Game Boy Advance with, what is it, Millipede and Super Breakout on it? But that's just, like, the straightforward Lunar Lander, sort of like how Pong for the Game Boy Advance is just Pong, period. This is a little bit pricier than most Game Boy games, but not the way I got it. This is Street Fighter Alpha Warrior's Dreams for the Game Boy Color. Again, obscenely cheap compared to what I would have paid. And lastly, oh, this is fucking hot. This is the early Sega Perfect catalog, which is just, like, you know how, like, Retro Gamer has those, like, annual special things or whatever where they compile stuff? This is kind of a magazine like that, except it's nothing but SG-1000, SC-3000, Mark III Master System and Game Gear, and it's a list of every single game and accessory. And, like, I guess that's rarity listings? Like, here's, like, the Game Gear. And here's, like, the inside of the Game Gear. And, like, this is pretty intense. I kind of like... Let me get the Obi strip off of there. I think that's an Obi strip. Is it still an Obi strip if it's not on a CD? Oh my god, this has the receipt from the bookstore in it. Oh, here's the Sega AI computer, which I believe never came out. Anyway, this is fucking ill. It's like 200 pages and absolutely something that only I would care about. It looks like they've got the Australian and New Zealand stuff in here too. So, allow me to tell you what I saved. How Sendico works is you put your money in a wallet, like you would put your money into a PayPal or Venmo account. It's automatically converted into yen. And then you just bid on auctions, like you would bid on auctions. You just have to have the money there ahead of time. My throat's drying out, so I should probably have some alcohol. There is a 500 yen per item fee. And then when you compile it all together into a parcel, that's 500 yen. But let me tell you here, this thing here, the SG-1000 pouch, the cheapest one on eBay is $13.99 with $25 shipping. So that's $38.99. I paid $11. This copy of Street Fighter Alpha, the cheapest one I found was $71 with free shipping. I paid $30. There's cents in there. I'm just leaving those out because I'm lazy. Lunar Lander. $35.750 shipping on eBay for a total of $42.50. I paid $17.01. Oh, this catalog. This I almost got on eBay because it's $49 free shipping. But I paid 27, so that's kind of awesome. Hustle Chumy, in a condition that's actually kind of... The cheapest one I found on eBay that's complete is a little beat up like this. But that one's $55 and $17 shipping, $72 total. I paid $19 for this. And lastly... there are plenty of loose Super Game Boy 2s, and there are plenty of boxed ones with nothing with them or just the manual. But the cheapest one, like I got with all the inserts, is $79.90 and 15 shipping, which is $94.99. I paid $48. Now, I could have maybe gotten one cheaper, but this was the first thing I ever got on Sendico, and bidding started at about $18, and I kind of went nuts trying to win it, so I probably could have done better than $48. Either way, that's still awesome. Shipping was $28.48 total. That's with the fee, the shipping consolidation fee. The package left Japan on Tuesday. It's Friday and it got here today. It would have gotten here Thursday, but the customs place in Cincinnati held it up for another day. So I could have had that in 2 days from Japan. So what this comes out to is from eBay, you would be paying $368.39 for everything, shipping included. I paid $181.97. That is with fees, and I can understand how people would complain about the fees. Like, that's 3,500 yen extra I paid. But keep in mind, would you rather just go to Yahoo Auctions, untranslated, and bid on everything yourself, and email the seller yourself, and get them to send it to America yourself? Without those fees, it would have been $150.13. But I don't know. I think I did okay. I think I'm kind of over the moon. As someone who recently misplaced their wallet, I think I'm kind of stoked to carry stuff around inside a fucking SG-1000. So yeah, maybe this isn't like my normal kind of video, but people tend to like unboxing stuff on YouTube, so I figured I'd give it a fucking shot. like, subscribe, maybe comment if you're not a prick. And I'll see you next week with more niche stuff that only I like, and that will probably get 25 views. Thanks for everything. That was sincere. That wasn't like me being an asshole.